what extended version.
Okay.
But then the Zingo one is their all English one.
Okay.
So which one do you guys want?
Yes.
English.
Okay. Let's watch
the Filipino one.
I'm just kidding.
One.
No,
I'll
yeah.
say Filipino.
Let's watch this
let's
one.
Let's watch the first one.
Okay, let's do what extended version. Okay.
Hey guys, just wanted to give you guys a disclaimer before we start this reaction video and, you know, just a little bit of context here. We actually filmed these reaction videos at 2 a.m. So if you guys see any of us having a little bit of like tiredness in the face, that's because of the hour and not because of anything that we're watching on the TV. We also had a couple of drinks, so if it's a little bit loud and chaotic, I really tried my best to put some captions on so you guys don't, like, you guys can hear everything. Also, I just wanted to let you guys know about my friends who are in the video, and I guess my more than friend, my boyfriend. So the two girls that you're gonna see in the video are actually K-pop stans. I also have another friend that's not on camera, but he speaks throughout. He is also a K-pop stan. So if you guys hear comments comparing to K-pop, that's just because that's all they know. So hopefully you guys don't take it against them. You know, they've never experienced P-pop or anything like that. So that's where they're all coming from. So it's definitely nothing against the boys or anything. If anything, you know, they were really impressed. So a little spoiler alert there. Like I said, my boyfriend is also in this video. Woo, boyfriend reveal. Anyway, I just wanted to let you guys know that he literally has no background when it comes to stan culture. He doesn't know K-pop, he doesn't know P-pop, he doesn't know J-pop, whatever. Like, his taste of music is completely different. So everything is so new to him. So if you hear him barely saying anything, and that's because he doesn't know what to say. He doesn't know how to react or anything like that. So hopefully you guys don't put that against him. And also, like I said, we were also tired. I kind of like forced him to be in the video and I felt so bad. But he was like such a good sport about it. But yeah, just wanted to give you guys that context as well. And lastly, if you guys hear my friends comment something where you're like, whoa, how do they know that? They don't even know SB19. That's because I already briefed them on some of the information about SB19. We actually filmed a podcast episode, me and my friends did, talking about stan culture in general, where we compared K-pop and P-pop stan culture and just talk about everything stanning, you know. So it was actually a really, really great conversation. So make sure to stay at the end of the video to get a sneak peek of that content and also my future contents, because there's going to be a surprise at the end. So make sure to stay towards the end of the video. Anyway, enough talking. Hope you guys enjoy the reaction.
I'm sorry. Okay, full blast, Melissa.
Full blast.
Let's go. Okay. Tita Mello, full blast.
What?
Let's go.
What?
What?
What? By SB19.
And this is...
Full blast, I said!
Okay. We need captions.
Yeah, can you put English captions, please? We are reacting to SB19's What music video? What year was this? 2021?
I forgot. Pablo. Ken,
I love Ken.
That's my bias.
Is Ken the Visayan one?
He's the Visayan one.
Ken. Okay, this is giving me very dark vibes, dark concept.
Wow. This song is meant to be militant.
Yes.
Okay. Right.
But it's like a personal anthem.
Very K-pop vibes.
SB19 was trained in Korea.
Yeah,
they were trained by a Korean
company. Yeah.
Oh, I see.
But makes sense. Which goes back to the like the Filipinos taking in many different genres and making it their own.
Yeah.
So it's very different.
Who has the cut eyebrows? Oh my gosh.
I do.
Maybe.
Wait, I do.
I'm so sorry, but
I've had it since before he.
No, but he's K-pop. Okay,
is it clean cut, nicely like hairstyle?
Ew, why did I lick my lips?
Because you're secretly bi. It's okay.
You tell me, Ally.
Melissa, who's this?
It's Stel!
I love Stel. Okay. Stel's jawline, though.
Well, the next one.
Oh, okay.
You don't know.
Nani G, cover yourself. I like the music a lot. It's very rap based, which is kind of similar to current K-pop is Stray Kids.
Oh yeah.
JYP.
Under JYP.
ITZY, Stray Kids, their new generation ones.
So JYP's more recent groups are very edgy. Like girl groups and guy groups, very edgy. So that's what they kind of remind me of.
Mm. What do you think, Manny G? He's someone who's not into K-pop so far, or P-pop.
Wait, what kind of music are you into normally?
Well, I'm using kind of like Latin music, so. But does this remind you of anything?
I mean, it's hard to tell because I don't know too much about K-pop.
Right.
But just from the little bit that I've been exposed to, those are the kind of vibes I'm getting from
them. But I mean, when you look at them, can you tell that they're Filipino? Visually, they look Filipino.
Yeah.
Yeah.
100%.
Yeah. Because I feel like they have stronger facial features, noses and jawlines compared to K-pop idols.
Right.
K-pop male idols.
Right. Yeah, okay.
And also, I don't know how much exposed you've been to Filipino language or Tagalog, Visayan, but...
Can you recognize Tagalog words with your Spanish background?
I mean, some words.
I feel like even...
Bandera! They said bandera.
I feel like even the rap is a little bit stronger.
No, because that's what it is. I feel like Filipino, Tagalog rap, I don't know what it is, there's a certain raspy and strength in them.
Yeah.
Maybe it's because of the syllabic nature of Tagalog. I don't know what it is, but the dance.
And of course they're very talented in dance.
Yeah.
This is very standard dance breaks I would see with K-pop groups too. Oh my god, why am I shy? It's the uniforms. I don't know. I'm shy, I'm so shy. Oh my god. Was that Pablo? Please stop.
No.
Pablo, that's Pablo. Justin.
Okay.
No, because the quality of this has been unheard of in Philippine music video. That's why it was trending so much.
Yeah. Because they were trained under a Korean entertainment, South Korean entertainment group.
Yeah. Don't need bullets just to raise my flag. How poetic.
Historical.
And I feel like Filipinos, the country of the Philippines tends to be perceived as a very rebellious culture.
Yeah, no, for real.
Rebellious, but we've also had so much.
We had a lot to rebel to because of all the oppression.
Tons of oppression.
From Western to other Eastern.
Yeah.
Oppressors.
We're the only Spanish colony that literally kept our language.
Yes.
And most of our culture. Period.
So you guys watched At First Sight of My Father?
I don't think so.
But on Netflix. I don't think it's in the female, actually.
These pretty boys. Oh my
gosh.
Oh,
wow.
Okay.
I didn't know about this and you suddenly put me on them. I might download them.
As an OG K-pop
fan. Okay, as an OG K-pop fan, yes? What do you think?
Open your eyes.
No, it was really good because they brought in like the military. Right?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And this is like your first time being exposed to like K-pop, right? Like, or anything of that matter.
Yeah.
Like, you've always just been in like an OG K-pop stan.
Yes.
Yeah.
I was Chinese
K-pop pop. Girl group.
I was
girl
Chinese.
Group. Girl group.
No, yeah, I was Chinese, Japanese, and then K-pop. And then K-pop just took all my attention.
Yeah. Did you like did you like the concept
though? Yeah, I absolutely loved it.
Yeah.
Very interesting to see, you know, like, oh, well, half Filipinos have.
Right.
Something that is militant as well. Talk about, you know, realizing our identity.
Yeah. And I think that's the biggest part of the song though. It's like all about like authenticity, like don't need bullets to wave my flag. Like that was literally one of the lyrics
historical
of it. Like you literally don't need anything to just be who you are. Like I feel like that really resonated
with me. Filipinos too, we've had a long history of, well, we can't have bullets, we can't have weapons, we can't have things because our oppressors have been like, you can't have any of that.
Yeah.
You can't do that.
Yeah, exactly.
So what do?
Yeah.
We can't do that. We can voice it, we can have
bullets. Right, right.
Which is really important about having our language.
Yes.
Because
exactly.
We can use our language to spread our words and to spread
period.
Our
words.
That's really interesting because like growing up in America, like being born here and my parents like trying to keep the language and customs would like try their best to teach me but at the same time want to assimilate.
Yeah.
But of course when you're assimilating, the language easiest to pick up is English because everyone talks it.
Right, right. And I feel like that's why I like really like about them is that almost all of their songs are in their native language. So even though they're trying to aim for like a global audience, they try to stick with their native language.
Yeah, no, that's just, I like it a lot. Like, first of all, the song is catchy, it's in their language, I really like that. And as I was watching the music video, I was like, oh. Now, like, they're all good looking, they're all very pretty looking.
Yeah.
Like, not like,
I mean, that's a good thing then.
Is there any, like, it's a good thing. But the song is catchy though.
Yeah,
like, I like it. Yeah.
He's the one with no shirt.
Josh. Angie, that's my bias.
I'm shy. Stop it. If you're gonna gently caress me on the face, I'll be like, oh, maybe I'm gonna step on you. Whoa, Pablo,
you need to
set, go.